Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. In this video, we will learn the basics of transistor biasing, like what is Qpoint and the load line. Transistor biasing is the process of providing DC voltage to transistor in order to keep it in optimal operating conditions or in active region. In transistor biasing, the emitter and base junction forward biased and collector and base junction reverse biased so that it can work as an amplifier. Amplification is one of the most common application of a BJT. It can increase the strength of a weak signal. For a transistor to act as an amplifier, it should be properly biased. Here, these three biasing resistors are used to set a specific DC voltage to the transistor terminals in order to maintain forward bias at emitter base junction and reverse bias at base collector junction. And in fact, the energy supplied by this DC supply is used to amplify the input signal. If we observe the common emitter configuration of a BJT, here it is biased in such a way that base emitter junction gets forward biased and base collector junction gets reverse biased. Here the voltage VBE and base current IB are the input characteristics, while the voltage VCE and collector current IC are the output characteristics. So after biasing, the BJT will be in active region. Now, if we apply sine wave input signal at the base of BJT, the BJT can amplify the small 0.1 volt input signal and we will get an amplified output signal at the load resistor RL. Here, the amplified output signal of a BJT amplifier depends on the biasing. So, proper biasing is crucial for the correct operation of a BJT amplifier. So, now let's understand this with output characteristic curve. Here, let's say that the BJT is biased in such a way that the VCE equals to 5 volts and the collector current IC equals to 5 milliamperes. At this point on the characteristic curve is known as the operating point or Q point of the BJT. Because this Q point tells about the operating voltage and the current of the BJT. Here, the base current IB equals to 40 microamperes. So, what we understood in this output characteristic curve is that this Q point tells us that the BJT is biased in such a way that the base current IB equals to 40 microamperes, VCE equals to 5 volts and collector current IC equals to 5 milliamperes. This operating point should be in active region, so it could be set anywhere. It could be in the center or it could be over here or it may be over here also. So whenever the operating point is over here on the top, if we apply AC input signal, then some portion of the amplified output signal will get clipped because here this voltage VCE cannot go below 0 volt. Similarly, whenever operating point is over here at the down, then also some portion of the collector current will get clipped because the collector current IC cannot go below 0 amperes. And due to this, some portion of VCE voltage will also get clipped. Therefore, whenever the operating point is near saturation or the cutoff region, then it may lead to non-linear distortion in the output waveform. If you notice over here, whenever the BJT operating in this region, then it is operating near the breakdown region. Hence, the operation of the BJT in this region must be avoided. On the other hand, when the operating point is at the center of the output characteristic curve, then input signal will be amplified correctly without any distortion. Here in this region, the gain of the BJT is almost constant. So for the small signal amplification, the Q point or operating point must be at the center of the output curves. Here, how stable this operating point is depends upon the temperature. Because with the change in temperature, the operating point will be gets changed. It is because with the change in temperature, the device parameters like current gain beta and the reverse saturation ICEO will get changed. Hence, the biasing circuit should give temperature stability such that Even if there is any change in temperature, then there must be no or minimum change in operating point. And the stability of the operating point defined by the term stability factor. This stability factor indicates the change in operating point with the change in the temperature. Let's see how stability changes with different types of biasing configurations. First of all, let's start with the simple fixed bias configuration. This is the circuit of fixed bias configuration. Here we will redraw or simplify this circuit for better understanding. So the same circuit can be redrawn like this. What we have done here? Simply denoted VCC and VBB with notations instead of battery symbols. Here the AC input signal is applied between base and emitter terminals, while the output derived across collector and emitter terminals. Now we will see the DC analysis of this circuit. For the DC analysis of this circuit, we can replace these capacitors with open circuit. It is because, as we know, that capacitors blocks DC and allows AC to pass through them. If we remove these two capacitors, then the new equivalent circuit will look like this. This configuration is known as fixed bias configuration. It is because for a fixed power supply, if we fix the value of this base resistor RB, then the base current IB will also get fixed. And here this voltage VBE is the voltage on the input side, while this voltage VCE is the voltage on the output side. Now let's find the expressions for the base current IB. If we observe over here, the voltage at this node is VBE. Hence from this we can say that this base current IB equals to VBB minus VBE divided by RB. As we know that the typical value of VBE equals to 0.7. So for the given supply voltage, once we set the value of RB, then this base current IB will get fixed. Alright, now we know the value of the base current IB. So we can find the value of this collector current IC and the voltage VCE. As we know that collector current IC equals to beta times IB. Now if we apply the Kirchhoff voltage law KVL in this output side, here consider the voltage drop across RC equals to VRC. The voltage drop across the transistor is VCE. So according to KVL, the algebraic sum of all the voltage drops are equals to the applied voltage. Hence VCC equals to VRC plus VCE. We can write this expression as VCC minus VRC minus VCE equals to 0. From this we can say that VCE equals to VCC minus VRC. That equals to VCC minus, here VRC can be written as IC into RC. Hence VCE equals to VCC minus IC into RC. So in this way we can also get the value of VCE. Here the voltage VCE and collector current IC defines the operating point of the transistor. Now from these three equations we can observe that if the value of these biasing resistors RB and RC changes, or the value of the VCC changes, then the operating point will also changes. So now let's see how these three network parameters defines the possible values of the operating point. Now from these expressions we can write collector current IC equals to VRC minus RC. Here this VRC is nothing but VCC minus VCE. So we can write IC equals to VCC minus VCE divided by RC. From this expression we can say that this collector current IC will be maximum whenever this voltage VCE is minimum. If this VCE is 0, then we will get maximum value of collector current. Hence IC max equals to VCC minus RC. So here in this graph we can denote IC max equals to VCC by RC, or whenever VCE is 0. Similarly, this collector current IC is minimum whenever this voltage VCE is maximum. So we can say that collector current IC equals to 0 when the voltage VCE is equals to VCC. Hence in this graph we can say that whenever this collector current IC equals to 0, at that moment the value of VCE equals to VCC. So if we join these two points, IC maximum and IC minimum, we will get all the possible values of the operating point for the given values of VCC and RC. So this line is also known as the load line because it is defined by the values of this load resistor RC. Now here, if the value of IB is changed by varying RB, then Q point will also changes. So for the given values of VCC and RC, if the value of IB is increased to 50 microamperes by decreasing the value of RB, then the Q point will also moves upwards. If we further increase the IB to 60 microamperes by decreasing RB, the Q point will further moves towards upwards. Hence, it is proved that if the value of IB varies, the Q point will also varies. Similarly, for a fixed value of VCC, if we change the value of RC, like here, if we increase the RC value to RC1, then IC decreases to VCC by RC1. So the load line will falls to this point. If we again increase RC1 to RC2, IC will further decreases to VCC by RC2. So the load will fall further to this point. So here, three different load lines are shown for the three different values of RC. Here, RC2 is greater than RC1 and RC1 is greater than RC. So here you can see that for the fixed value of base current, if the load line changes, then the operating point will also shift towards the left hand side. And now let's see what happens if we change the value of VCC by keeping the values of IB and RC fixed. If we reduce the value of VCC to VCC1, then the Q point and the load line changes to this position. If we further reduce the value of VCC1 to VCC2, then the load line will changes to this point. Here the different load lines are shown for the different values of VCC. What we have done here, we have reduced the values of VCC by keeping other values fixed. So the load line shifts towards left hand side. But let's say for the given value of VCC and RC, we are getting this operating point and load line. Here if the temperature changes, the operating point will also changes. It is because with increase in temperature, the beta or current gain of the transistor will increases. And if the temperature decreases, the beta gain will also decreases. Different transistors have different values of beta. The beta gain value of the transistor denoted in data sheet. It is also specified that similar transistors also have different values of beta. Now let's see how the variations in the beta gain can affect the operating point. So let's say for a given transistor, the nominal value of beta is 100, and due to change in temperature or due to the replacement of the transistor, the beta varies from 50 to 200. Here assume that voltage VBE is not changing with the temperature and base current IB is fixed at 40 microamperes. Now here let's say the value of RC equals to 1 kilo ohm and the value of VCC equals to 10 volt. Let's note the values. RC equals to 1 kilo ohm, VCC equals to 10 volt. So whenever the beta equals to 100, at that time this collector current IC will be equals to beta into IB. Here IB equals to 40 microamperes. So IC equals to 100 into 40 microamperes. That equals to 4 milliamperes. Now if we calculate the value of VCE, then it will be equals to VCC 10 volt minus IC 4 milliamperes multiplied with RC 1 kilo ohm. That equals to 10 volt minus 4 volts. That gives the value of VCE as 6 volts. So this operating point is here. That means VCE is equals to 6 volts and the collector current IC equals to 4 milliamperes. Now let's say we have replaced the transistor and due to that the new value of the beta is 50. So when beta equals to 50, then the collector current IC is equals to 50 into 40 microamperes. That equals to 2 milliamperes. Now if we calculate calculate the value of VCE, then it will be equals to 10 volt minus 2 milliamperes into 1 kilo ohm. That equals to 10 volts minus 2 volts. That equals to 8 volts. That means whenever the value of beta is 50, then the operating point would be somewhere around here. Because at that time, the value of VCE equals to 8 volts and the value of IC equals to 2 milliamperes. Similarly, let's observe when the value of beta becomes 200. Now the collector current IC equals to 200 into 40 microamperes. That equals to 8 milliamperes. Now the value of VCE will be equals to 10 volts minus 8 milliamperes into 1 kilo ohm. That equals to 10 volts minus 8 volts. That equals to 2 volts. That means whenever the value of beta is 200, then the operating point would be somewhere around here. Because at that time, the value of VCE equals to 2 volts and the value of IC equals to 8 milliamperes. So this load line graph shows the minimum and maximum possible changes in the operating point due to the change in the temperature or due to change in the transistor. That means in this fixed bias configuration, even if we set the fixed value of the base current, then also operating point may be vary due to the change in external parameters. That's all about the basics of the transistor biasing. If you have learned from this video, please do mention them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.